Teddy from Switzerland, today with another custom knife unboxing. And this time I'm really proud of myself because this package arrived on Monday, which is now 6 days ago, and I managed to keep it all sealed up and didn't peek into it to do the unboxing here now live on the channel. And I couldn't do it before, just hadn't the time, and because I record at daylight, I only get a couple of hours each day where I actually can do videos, because it's winter now and it gets dark very early. And you can see this thing is also coming from Polish Custom Knives. You see it with the bandage that's around it. And here we have also the great sticker I got with this knife right here, which I already unboxed. This is also from Polish Custom Knives. This is a JK Knives Dwarf. Absolutely amazing piece that has been with me for a couple of weeks now. And you will see a full review of the JK Knives Dwarf later on the channel. But I will use this here to unbox my second purchase from Polish Custom Knives. Let's put the patch back right here, and it's from a different maker than this JK Knives Dwarf. And let's dig into the packaging here, cutting both sides right there, and let's see what we got here. So let me know if you have bought anything from Polish Custom Knives. The experience I had was very nice, great and fast shipping. Of course, for me it's a bit faster than for most guys in the US because I'm in Switzerland and Poland is not that far away in comparison to the US. We will leave the JK Knives Dwarf up here for you to look at. And they were great to talk to. They're very responsive on Instagram. So if you're interested in them, I will leave a link in the description to Polish Custom Knives, as well as to JK Knives Instagram, which is also a great guy to deal with, and to the maker of the knife that is in this box. So let's unbox this. So this is a maker I heard from quite a bit. Never had the chance to actually handle one of them, but on the last drop I actually had to get the knife. I think this is just packing material, but we will dig into that later as well. And then we have the knife right here, and we have the certificate. We put those to the side so we don't give away what exact model and knife this is already. Putting the packaging to the side, and this one right here. And now let's do the unboxing. So I'm very excited to finally experience this maker here. And it comes, of course, in the great Polish Custom Knives padded pouch with the Herman knives here on the back. But let's tear into this one. It feels very lightweight, I can say that. And now let's reveal the knife. And it's a Herman. Of course, I knew that. And wow, this looks awesome. First time I have... And there goes the packaging. First time I actually have this kind of carbon fiber, and the first time I actually have a Herman in hand. And this is the Sting model. So I'll do a bit of a close-up here in the 4K video. Of course, we get the proprietary pivot there. We get the tool in the box, I think. Yeah, here you can see that's the tool. We get another patch. Very cool. And here you can see the specification. So it's the Sting serial number 151, 61HRC, and it's M398, which was something that I was actually very excited about. I never had a knife in M398, so not M390, M398. And then I also really loved how this like antiqued bronze titanium looked on the pictures, and then I really had to grab it. You can also see some great inlay work there. Very nicely done. Absolutely awesome work here on the titanium backspacer. Herman Knives does some very cool backspaces. He also often uses carbon fiber, but I think here in this great finish on the titanium, it looks awesome. Very unique and special pocket clip design with the milling underneath. And then you have the exposed ends of the screws that have been nicely polished and domed. But let's do the first deployment here. You can also see a nice way to do a captive pivot there. And that's nice. Of course, this was laying around now for a bit. Centering seems to be a tiny bit off. We'll certainly try to fix that with the included. Ooh, nice. The detent is very good. And the ergonomics. Wow. For my hand size, this is very, very comfortable. Really nicely done. And the great thing here is that we have an inset titanium liner lock. So there's no way you can interfere with the action while putting pressure on the lock bar. And it has that Herman ting I was hearing about so much to it. So you can hear that. It makes a ting, a very resounding sound to it when you deploy it. No wiggle or anything there. And here you can see M398 on the blade. We have some kind of a stonewash or media blast finish to the blade right there. The Herman knives is nicely done there, the logo. And very easy to access that liner lock. No lock stick. That's nice. Probably needs a bit of lubrication, but still drops nicely. And has a very, the sound gets kind of louder the more you deploy it. Very cool. So ergonomically, this is really amazing. Great overall size. You can feel the clip a tiny bit when really bearing down, but when you hold it normally, you just notice that it's there, but it is not uncomfortable at all. If we take a look at the edge, it seems to be quite thin. Very nice. Good tip there. You have the exposed stop pin, the nice ramp, so you can deploy it comfortably. The flipper tab has a bit of a hook design to it, so there's a little bit of a curvature there with a little bit of an edge. So you can feel that while deploying, but it's not hurting or anything. So very, very cool. Love the finish on the titanium. Really well done. I'll try to fix the centering right now, but before that, we just do some size comparison. So the Sting model here from Herman Knives, from Polish Custom Knives, and you can see these two are very similar in overall sizing. We also can show it against a Shiro Gorov that is probably very close in size, the Neon Zero. And you can see these are very close in overall size, and it's quite a bit smaller than, for example, an F95 NL that you see right here. So a great EDC friendly folder here from Polish Custom Knives and Herman Knives out of Poland. And here you can see the two against each other. So very different designs, but both really amazing. Very interested to try out the M398 in terms of performance. And very happy that I finally have a Herman in hand. And this is really lightweight. Probably there is some internal milling in there. Yeah, there is some very noticeable internal milling in there. I'll show you with the very nicely done. And here you can see Sting 2021. Very nicely done. So the show scale has some milling. The lock side scale has also some milling. Very cool. So really impressed so far with the Herman Knife Sting. Love the inlay work and this gorgeous bronze anodization. And we will see how well the M398 is performing on this Sting. And please check out Polish Custom Knives if you're looking to get an Herman knife for yourself, or a JK Knives Dwarf. I think both of them have some models available on Polish Custom Knives. Check out the description for all the links. Thanks for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.